Ooh, what's wrong with this thing? Excuse me, family. I'm trying to get this together. Okay, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, my illustrious family. How y'all like my background? On the road again. It's so nice to be on the road again. I'm just making music with my friend, and I can't wait to get on the road again. Look at them beautiful stores. There's a full moon. Where the moon at? Ain't no moon out there. It's just some stars. Anyway, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, family. Welcome to the Mental House on this Saturday night. How y'all be? No, I be very well. I can't complain. Been doing a lot of packing still. Y'all know I'm packing. I got a whole house to pack up. Lord have mercy. And I don't know when we ever getting out of here, but my stuff gonna be packed. That's for damn sure. My dog has been acting crazy. She's been sitting in here eating pistachios. So let me get my mind off of that and talk about what I really came here for. You know, one of my favorite young nieces, my young nieces out here, I would say, content creators that I watch a considerable amount of content from. I like her style and I like her content. So shout out to Lovely T. And, you know, I didn't know that she was a wrestling fan. She's in Minnesota. I'm in Wisconsin. So we pretty much experienced the same weather. We in this Midwest and it's real freaking cold. Except they had a snowstorm. We missed it. We didn't get all the damn snow that they got. But pretty much, when you talk Minnesota, Chicago, Milwaukee, you know, just we wasn't what. But anyway, she did a video about talking about wrestling. And I didn't know she was such a fan. But however, in her speaking of that, I wanted to tell y'all a story that I know about a wrestler that was here that was going with one of my mom's friends. And his name was Ken Patera. And I don't know for all of y'all wrestling fans out there that remember Ken Patera. He's old school. I mean, I love wrestling too. So when I heard that, I was really, really impressed. I was like, well, let me tell one of these wrestling stories that I know. Because y'all know I'm old as dirt. And ain't too much stuff we talk about that y'all could talk about with me that I don't know or have any kind of knowledge of whatsoever. So I'm pretty well versed on a lot of stuff. So when she said wrestling, of course, that brought up Ken Patera. And I want to tell y'all a story. For some of y'all, this is not funny. And for some of us, every time we think about it, we crack up. We just go crazy. So, Ken Patera is an old school wrestler. And so, for those of y'all who remember Ken Patera, please make a comment below. He was out of that same vein with, let's see, who? You know, the Crusher was from Milwaukee. You know, Dick the Bruiser was before my time. But I remember the Crusher, and Ken Patera, Dirty Dusty Rose, Mad Dog Bashan, Kenny J. He used to get beat up all the time. Vern Gagne, all these guys, right? So when they had a conversation about wrestling, of course, it brought up the story. So I know y'all saying, get to it, right? Okay, let me tell you about it. Ken Patera, I believe, was suffering from what a lot of these wrestlers are suffering from. I forgot what it's called, but it's like a CTE type of, brain disorder. So Ken Patera was out in the hotel going This is a story about Ken Patera. A true story, by the way. And this is what happened to... what happened? Anyway, he was in the hotel with a mistress. Let's just put it that way. Because my mom's friend was very angry about it, right? But of course, y'all know what happens when you marry to or you messing around with an athlete. Anything goes. Unfortunately for a lot of those guys that was on them steroids and stuff back then, you know, it wasn't like their stuff was working, but it was an opportunity to use drugs, okay? Well, whatever happened up in the room with the woman and stuff, if I remember the story correctly, the cops were called on Ken Patera, okay? Now, the cops came and tried to arrest him. And he was straight bonkers. He started throwing them all up against the walls. They had to call. They kept calling for backup. But all the backup that he called, they called, he beat up. And no one wanted to, of course, shoot him. Because, you know, he was the famous wrestler, Ken Patera. But they finally got him under control. But it took, I think, if I'm not mistaken, about 13 officers to contain him. And he tore up the hotel. I mean, he just tore it the complete up on one of them binges. Now, he was on some kind of steroids, just like Lau Alzado. What's the other one? They from Oak Creek. John Matuzak. I think John Matuzak went on to play for the Raiders. Yeah, right? Lau Alzado. These guys are Wisconsin guys. And they indulged in steroids. And so, while a lot of that stuff we think about, and they were acting so crazy and would be involved in such a lot of craziness, at the end of the periods of a lot of their lives, you knew that they were taking steroids because their bodies had become such a frail shell of what it used to be. What's the dude's name? Green Bay Packers drafted. He was... John, what was his name? The big hulky dude, and everybody he went number one. The Packers used him for a number one pick. Mandarin, or I can't think of his name right. He was such a bust because the NFL started doing a lot of testing when he came to be, and so what happened was it was so messed up that I guess he stopped taking them. And all of a sudden, you just saw his body shrink. Somebody help me who I'm talking about out here. Y'all know this is an impromptu conversation. And my channel was so relaxed. Sometimes I don't think about these people and I need y'all help. So help me out with this. Who was that? Who am I talking about? Anyway, somebody will leave it. Note and description. But I'm saying a lot of those wrestlers that were on those steroids, one of them killed his wife and his kids. I mean, and I don't know, like I said, the price of fame sometimes. Sports, the price. And some about using these performance enhancing drugs, you know, it's just It might do what you needed to do in the short term, but sometimes the long term effects of these things are really damaging and detrimental and just really downright deadly. And so I thought about Ken Patera because Ken was a good guy, you know, and but he would have those bouts where he would just go totally, totally bonkers. And yes, I am talking about the great Ken Patera, the wrestler. Yes, 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 yes. Look it up. So, that catalyst to that, the story, as I thought about, because I love wrestling too, and I'm an old school wrestler. How many of y'all used to remember All-Star Wrestling that used to come on every week? I don't know. In Wisconsin, it came on like every Saturday. And we would get, you know, it was like roller derby. Yeah, you had roller derby, and then you had All-Star Wrestling. Oh, I mean, boy. Woo! Mad Dog Bashan, all those guys. Like I said, I could go on and on about All-Star Wrestling. How many of y'all out there are wrestling fans? Let me know in the comments below. And I'll see you in the next video.